Hello and welcome back to Adrift. In the last episode we managed to get to the Cerebrum and now we were tasked with repairing the Spiritus part of the mainframe. So Spiritus says life support systems over there. There are other wings that we'll need to do other bits and bobs for later on. But we'll check those out later on. We can't go down there anyway. We have to finish Spiritus first. And basically, we have to do each of the wings in order. So, without further ado, let's get going. Get some forward momentum there. Yeah, Spiritus access wing. Let's pick up this data pad.
Personal log. Systems specialist. McDonough, Andrew. 17. April. 2037.
Finally going home. Doesn't even seem real. 22 months since mission start. 10 longer than I signed up for in the first place. I promised Lucy I was going to be there for her. I promised myself I wouldn't leave her like this again. Broke both of those promises by taking another selfish paycheck job while real life passes me by down below. Father of the year. Alex really came through for me on this. I owe her one. Can't wait to get off this goddamn station.
So McDonough was needing to get off to look after his daughter, and we're the person that was supposed to have sorted that out for him. This is his quarters, so we're going to read his contact information now. Alex, Lynn contacted me already. Everything is in motion. Can't thank you enough for this. Got a lot of missed time to make up for down there. Collins is solid. He's smart, eager, and doesn't have the baggage I do. He's slated for Han 5. So calling him up here early will be a big break for him. Good choice. Maybe I can help with early beta. Let me know. Andrew. Andrew, Lynn Collette from Hardiman Resource will be contacting you to work everything out. She also places for Vancouver, so that will be very good for you down the road. I'll need you right up to Spiritus Beta and Crew Expansion. So that looks like 8th of July transfer, maybe even before then. I'm working out how to get us to beta earlier, so it's a possibility. For your replacement, I'm considering bringing up Misha Collins. Thoughts? So we're kind of going backwards in the communication. Alex, absolutely interested. Visitation between Santa Monica and Vancouver will be a challenge, but we'll figure it out. What are the details? Is there anything I need to do to move the process along? Do I need to source my replacement? Thanks, Andrew. Andrew, called in a favor and got a transfer lead for you. The job is in Santa Monica, heading up Han 5 system assembly. I think your experience on this mission makes you a good fit. You know what works and what doesn't up here. You're in a unique position and aerospace needs help in this area more than ever. I know this isn't perfect for you location-wise, but it's stable, pays well, and most importantly, gets you off North Star. This is time-sensitive, so let me know if this is something you still want to pursue. So, basically McDonough's come to us for help about getting a transfer, and we've oiled the cogs, or the wheels. Now, we come down here and we can see the door is red right now. Now, I'm damaging my suit by bashing into all of this stuff. Let's make sure there's no hard drives down here, which I don't think there is. Okay. If you're up against a wall, the game will actually allow you to use the wall or the floor or whatever as leverage. Leverage, depending on how you like to say these things. So we have to come out this way, and now we're at risk again. I'm going to get a little top up of air here. Thank you very much. And we're heading off over this way. So you can see from here the devastation that has taken place. There's lots of junk flying about, which you need to be wary of. I believe if you damage your suit too much, it's kind of game over. Keeping an eye out for hard drives, but they are quite difficult to spot.
North Star 4, this is Mission Control. Unable to determine current location or crew status. Please advise. Over.
So, Ground Control still trying to get hold of me. I'm unable to contact them right now. The oxygen's... it's okay. I'll give myself some downward vector right now. And the air's starting to be a problem, so I'm going to get a little top up here. Very gently does it. Grab this one here. There we go. Let's get into the next section. Now if you look at the bottom of the screen, you can see velocity on the left and direction on the right. These are actually quite handy. When you get used to how they read out, they're quite handy to let you know whether you're at full speed in the direction you're currently facing. So use those to your advantage. Now obviously, you know, you're watching this, which means you're probably not playing it, unless you just like watching me play games. But in any case, if you don't own the game already, I do recommend it. It's definitely worth a good play. Do you copy? Right. So we're just transitioning off to the next part. Again, keeping an eye out for the hard drives, so I can't really see any at the moment. Now, when I went through my first pass through, I think I only got about 15 of the hard drives out of 25. I suspect that you need to kind of venture out to get more.
Administrator Series 4, version 2.3. How may I assist you? Assist you. Assist you. Assist you. Assist you. Assist you.
Okay, that wasn't working very well. Just a handy hint, if you're coming up to something that has an F action key on it, you don't necessarily need to slow down for it, and it's a little cheat way to not use oxygen to slow yourself down. Here's one of the hydroponics bays. There's a data pad. Oh no, that's just a plant. I thought that was a data pad then. Yeah, so when you press F, it slows you down automatically, so it kind of brings you up to the thing that you're targeting. So yeah, just a little bit of a cheat there. Right, let's get through this door. And here we've got another one of those doors. I'm at full speed. I press the button and it slows me down. Ah! quick look around. No, there must be some data pads here somewhere. Okay, I can't see any right now, so let's just carry on for now.
Mission control to North Star 4 survivors. Do you copy?
Okay, let's check out this door. And here we have a tree in space. Behold. I'm not sure what that is. I'm assuming that's a cherry blossom, but I'm not 100% sure. Right, so... the little map, mini map, is telling us to go that way. So we shall go that way after just going the long way around a little bit, just to make sure we're not going to miss anything. Anything, so I'm gonna carry on up this way. So you've got WSAD as standard, and then you've got control for downward and spacebar for up. It takes
it. This is mission control.
When I'm not being interrupted. It takes a little bit of getting used to kind of, you know, to do things very efficiently. Right, there's a hard drive in here somewhere.
Hand 4 audio terminal version 4.3 located. Multiple audio terminals detected and online. Location coordinates unknown.
So here's an audio terminal, however, on the C drive. C drive. Corrupt. But let's listen to Madonna.
Incoming communication. Hardiman Aerospace. Incoming communication. Hardiman Aerospace confirmation of transfer. 16 April 2037. Transfer status approved. Approver, Commander Oshima, Alex. Recipient, Systems Specialist, McDonough, Andrew. Mission, North Star 4. Departure date, 8 July 2037. Method, Resupply Shuttle. Destination, Hardiman Aerospace Launch Facility, Santa Monica, California. Replacement, Collins, Misha, Indigo Kai.
Okay, so that was just a confirmation of McDonough's escape plan. There we go, there's another one of these doors. I've got to keep an eye on my oxygen level right now. Make sure I don't overcommit. Got some oxygen on the way here, so that's okay.
Personal log. Systems Specialist, McDonough, Andrew. 2 July 2037.
Home in 6 days. Feels like 600. I'm gonna do it different this time.
Thank you.
Donna.
Looks like poor old Madonna didn't make it. Madonna? McDonna. And we can take a little look out of this. There's not much out here. Don't think there's anything to grab out here. No, I'm gonna head back. I don't want to waste my oxygen. So it does really pay to kind of get your alignment right before giving yourself some acceleration. Right, on with the mission. Total carnage. Although, I think in reality, this lot would just be moving around all over the shop.
North Star 4, this is Mission Control. Catastrophe signal received. Do you copy?
I do receive, but you can't receive me. Okay, let's pick up some more air. Thank you. And now we're back to a more safe environment. And the little diamond shape is telling us to go to the right, so let's do that.
Hardiman Aerospace, North Star 4. Crew status. Medical Officer, Edwards, Liam. Deceased. Scientist, Hudson, Elizabeth. Deceased. Astronaut, Lopez, Teresa. Deceased. Systems Specialist, McDonough, Andrew. Deceased. Astronaut, Olivier, Sebastian. Deceased. Commander, Oshima, Alex. Active.
Yeah, everyone's dead. So this little mission is to repair this wing takes quite a time. We're now heading towards the Spiritus mainframe, finally.
Hardiman Aerospace, North Star 4. Core system status, Spiritus mainframe, offline. Vocalis mainframe, offline. Solaris mainframe, offline. Mobilis mainframe, offline. Manual mainframe repair required for Salvis EEV operation and launch.
So, for the Salvis launch, we need to repair all of the wings, which I did say in the previous video. Got to watch out for these sparks here. They're not good at all. Right. Let's get some upward vector. A little bit too much downward. And up. There we go. Not too much. And then F to save us. So there's an SSD in there somewhere. I need to find that on the way back out. Now we're into the Spiritus mainframe.
Activating Spiritus system terminal. Mainframe online. Initializing hand 4 EVA diagnostic sequence. EVA oxygen repair detected. Initialize EVA oxygen repair.
Yes, please.
EVA oxygen capacity 100%. Exit EVA diagnostic environment.
So each time we...
Initializing cerebrum core diagnostic sequence.
Yeah, each time we do one of these core parts, cerebrum we get to repair an element of our spacesuit.
Fabrication.
Let's make this.
Cerebrum core fabrication complete. Cerebrum module repair required.
There we go. Now we go all the way back over there. Right, as you can see, we now have much greater air capacity, which is going to help the loads. Let's snag this hard drive over here. Thank you. Right, we're now back pretty much at the start of the Spiritus part of the space station, the access wing. There's a few other areas to explore around here, some more data to pick up, so before you head back, it's worth coming out here.
Version 2.3. Unable to establish communication connection with mission control.
You are receiving a global information network update.
Sources are reporting that a single survivor has been detected alive within the wreckage of the North Star 4. While Hardiman Aerospace has yet to confirm or deny, early reports are identifying the survivor as North Star 4 Mission Commander Alex Lucini. Activity detected aboard the station indicates the survivor is uninjured, following disaster protocol and preparing an emergency return to Earth.
For instant updates, stay connected to Global Information Network stream.
So there we pick up another SSD and we're going to head back into the space station, but we'll go around the loop that's being presented to us for right now. You can see that you know, at times we're seeing a nighttime view of the Earth, which is very cool. And now you can see we're back in that kind of hub room. We can now head back towards the main space station. Before we do that, let's get a top up of air. As you can see, we're back at the tree, and I believe the way we want to head down is over that way, but there are a few other areas to check out around here, so let's do that. I'll snag a canister before I do that. Now this tunnel looks like the loadout screen.
Personal log. Systems specialist. McDonough, Andrew. 11 June 2037.
Lucy's recital is a note-perfect Beethoven Sonata No. 8. Every time I hear it, I think about how I never got to where she is now. I gave up my dream a long time ago. I can see her achieving and surpassing it every time she performs. I had to struggle and work so hard, and she'll never know that feeling. She's got the gift I never had. I can hear it in her playing. It's natural. Effortless. Beautiful. I'm so proud of her.
Okay, that one, or that way, was a complete waste of time. I recommend avoiding that one, because there wasn't really much. I mean, you can get to the satellite that's out there, and you would pick up a little bit of information, but there aren't any SSDs out there, so just be aware. I'm going to check out this way, and right away I can see an SSD right in front of me.
Heading for EVA repair station located.
And we got a repair station this side as well. Get some repair on. All good.
Hand for EVA repair sequence complete. Vital signs stable.
You get some free air for that as well. We got another data pad over here as well. Look, let's pick that up.
Personal log. Systems specialist. McDonough, Andrew. 2 May 2037.
Lucy has moved on from resentment to indifference in our weekly vidcoms. It's been a week since she sent the new piano piece. The transfer news barely registered with her. I guess I'm not surprised. This is a pattern for me. I thought she'd at least be happy to hear I'm coming home. But I've disappointed her too many times to count at this point. I've done some real damage to her. To us. By being part of this mission.
Okay, so McDonough's really kind of screwing up his personal life and putting work in front of it. Here we have another SSD. So let's snag this. And I can just see there's another data pad. So we're 6 out of 25 SSDs.
Personal log, systems specialist, McDonough, Andrew, 29, June, 2037.
Whole rupture in irrigation caused a massive power outage while I was on spacewalk replacing soldiers today. Station dark, comms out for 23 of the longest minutes of my life. Thought this is it. Tried patching audio from my PDD so I could at least hear Lucy on the way out, but couldn't grab signal. Floating there in silence. Waiting for the end. I really saw how selfish I've been with her. I have to change.
Okay, there's nothing else out here, so I'm gonna head back. Okay, so we're back at the tree, and now we need to head back to the main station, which I think is out this door here. There we go. We can see the cerebrum now. It's our objective is insight. this mission takes a while, and in fact so do the others, so I'm gonna have to do a lot of chopping in the edit room. Okay, just stocked up on air. I went out that window just to make sure there wasn't any SSDs hanging around outside, but there weren't, so we're gonna head back in. And on our way back in, we're going to access this terminal right here. The Filtrum system.
Spirit is Filtrum coolant module offline.
Attempt reconnect. I think I'll try that. Thank you very much.
Spirit is Filtrum coolant module online. Hand 4 Filtrum coolant system operating at 25%.
Oh, that's one section. One section on the Filtrum side of things working. We've still got to go back up to the Cerebrum to complete this mission. So we've just got back to the Cerebrum main kind of control room. And we've just finished Spiritus Wing, you know, the repairs to that, and you can see the salvage down there, which you can say is the emergency escape vehicle, and that's the bit we're trying to get working. But the bit we need to do now is to go up here. Just make sure I don't need to access the terminal again.
Activating Spiritus System Terminal. Mainframe online. Cerebrum core detected. Cerebrum module repair required. Activate Cerebrum Access Portal. Cerebrum Access Portal online.
So we've just opened the Access Portal. This is now opening up. We can head up through here. As you can see, we've got some more hydroponics going on in here. It is a little bit funny. The leaves seem to cause you to stall a little bit, but in reality, a leaf does not carry enough momentum to do that. So we're now in the cerebrum, and you can see here we've got the Spiritus terminal right in front of us. So let's head over to that and fix the Spiritus part of the cerebrum. And now that's back online. So now we can head back and set about starting the next repair job of the next wing. Which I think, if memory serves me correctly, it's Vocalis. Because we need to get the comms back online. There's a little air terminal over there if you need it. But to be fair, if you're not kind of constantly using your thrusters, you really don't need the amount of air that they actually make available for you in the game. It's just the very, very first part that, you know, you might run into a little bit of trouble. We're back in the main control room now, and if I just correct my orientation, Vocalis is next. Anyway, I'm going to leave this episode here. I hope you enjoyed Adrift again. We have now repaired the Spiritus arm of the Han 4 Administra. And yeah, we're moving on to Vocalis, the communications array. After this. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to hit like, share and subscribe if you did, and I'll see you all in the next Adrift video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye for now.